I didn't even see that. I was
well, as Dave Murray comes by here, he's making his gear down pass to the brake. And he's setting up for a downwind leg coming into a landing. Setting up for final on his landing, and we'll be in here in just 1 second. The first aircraft that came by is what we call a Super Sterling. Super Sterling is a modified version of a PT Sterling, a PT-17 during World War II. PT stands for Primary Training. That team is just above Lincoln. That's a PT Sterling right there, just before about 2 miles out of the range for you. Well, after the war, they put a bigger motor on it, they put a little set of barrel out, the spinner made a more performant barrel back. Just Super Sterling. We're playing now with John Halstein. The Granville brothers have been great passes to build a unique, almost cartoon scale aircraft. And they've many variants in the R1, I think through the R3 or R4. And these John put the final to call that the DBZ, which was one of the last in the series. DBY, I'm sorry, the second last in the series of the Granville brothers aircraft. The pilots aren't flying barefoot because the rudder pedals are so sensitive they wanted every last bit of sensitivity they could gather and they could feel out of that aircraft so they could be successful with it. If you Google on YouTube anything about TV passes, you'll see all of it. Full scale ones, models, called career records for a reason. Fly model airplanes. We follow them up, we wad them up, we think about the next airplane we're going to fly. That's the beauty of modeling. Also, what you see is a PT-19 just flown by Army Rebel. Once again, PT, primary fan, 19 is model designation. That's the second aircraft. That's the second aircraft. Once again, you have PT camera, an instructor, and a pilot. Nice presentation by PT-19. On some of these aircraft. We use primarily, with the exception of jets, two primary types of engines, combustion engines. What we call a nitro engine, which is a nitro methane type of fuel, we call it burn fuel in the industry. Or gasoline, very typical fuel, we flash the satellite. gasoline engine that has that little previous oil in it, technically doesn't really give off any kind of smell, odor, or smoke. But those micro, those central running engines can see that they've got a little nice puff of white smoke as they go by them. That's not smoke anymore. That's just the methane burning off and gives these nice little smoke triple and actually a nice little sweet smell to boot.
Primarily the pieces that they took off.
Stand up, wave your hand. You, blue shirt, come on down. Hi, what's your name?
Ronnie.
Ronnie, I'm Chuck. Nice to meet you. Please get the teacher out there. We're going to do a little system check. Are you going out there before?
No.
Why are you here?
Well, I only came to watch. I want to learn.
Well, you got to a great place. Let's we'll go talk to me.
Let's get this thing back.
down, there you go.
Oh, calm down. All right, deep breath, deep breath.
Okay, we got this. Oh, we got it. We're good.
Woohoo!
Okay, we got this thing under control. Chuck, are we okay out there?
I got two boner over, guys.
Oh, this is okay. Looks like they got it down now.
All right,
they got it back on.
Yes! Oh, wait, it's a failure, guys. Oh, smoke! Hey, let's get this thing under control.
Nothing to worry about, ladies and gentlemen. You're far enough away from this that it's not a danger to you at all. So please relax.
Woo! Woo! Okay, looks like Lee's got it. Man, I'm terrible. I gotta go play my buddy. I'll pack a bundle for guys.
Okay, Lee's got it back again.
Hey, Lee. There you go. You got it.
So it's not as easy as it looks, folks.
I can't believe you've been on the bus. Hey, Roddy.
Big round.
All right, guys. Jokes on us.
Jamie Gideon, there's your pilot.
He's got a little bit of a shelter he can put out here for you.
I thought it might have been a little light.
So that there was a couple of colors.
These were really the only day of flight.
There was no heated suits. These guys fought the element. Not only did they fight the element, the cold weather, these aircraft constantly spit out oil, fuel, rain on them. They had castor in their mouth. Engines were highly reliable. Establishing them off the airplane. And we're running no parachutes at that time. Land on the wall, the guys develop parachutes to save them, and choose not to warm. They're fighting out there.
To the south end of the field, we have that big white pole. We have what they know as what they call a dead stick. That's the propeller stop spinning. That's the pole when it spins, big disc, big shot, big wheel that pulls you to the sky. Once that disc stops spinning, your airplane basically becomes a lead weight. And basically pushing those down, find a safe place to land, and come back and find out why she dead stick.
That is what we need to have a great effect. Because it was not considered fast enough or maneuverable enough to be able to get away from the enemy aircraft. Coming together are now two Fokker D-7s. One flown by Andy Gideon and Dennis Cook. The blue one is flown by Dennis Cook. He's over there from Hobart. I see New Washington's aircraft is down over there at the edge of the runway on the light.
And it looks like the Falcon B-7 is coming in for a landing here. Most of the aircraft, the World War I aircraft, did not have tail wheels on. They had what they call a tail skid. They come in and they pack them straight in, and then the ground crew would turn them around and pick up the rear end, back side of the aircraft, and then turn it around for them and put it in place while it's standing there. Well, we're retrieving our World War I aircraft. We're going to start to change the gear a little bit. We're going to advance the technology to just before the beginning of World War II. In 19... the enemy looking for targets. Radio in the back, because radio was, although in its infancy, was still highly prized, and they were also developing radar at the time. Although radar now determines whether they find the target today, back then it wasn't quite developed like that. So they would send out scouts, and they would search around looking for the targets and advancing the enemy, what have you.
Okay, we got some control planes up there, folks. Searching for the enemy diligently. These guys would fly 10, 12-hour missions. I'm telling you, then they'd get back on the ground for 8 hours, make a quick turnaround, and they're back in the air again. And during all of this, the Andrews sisters are singing Boogie Google, every Boogie Google Boy.
Well, when the scout, control plane, the scout the enemy is out the flare,
Supremacy over Elkhart, Indiana.
The Heritage fly here shortly. SPD is down. How about everybody give a wave to the general? I can see that smile on his face all the way to here.
Let's get a little tiny camera looking back at.
We're going to retrieve the B-25 here, and then the general will make a wing waddle wave to us all. Yellow Rose is down on the ground. And here comes the general here shortly. He'll be making
down at the south end of the field.
He's making sure
that our skies are safe. That we've defeated the Axis. We're just waiting for a signal. There it is, folks. Let us know our skies are safe. We have won the war.
Yeah. hopefully they land. We're going to be down there.
Okay. Working on it.
Up on the stand, and you're not gonna get executed. Oh. And there's Noel. Air show pilots front and center, right now.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, my pilots. We're so proud. Don't go away. We're flying all day. Flight time is open. Come on, come on. Come on. Go get a hot dog. Go get a coke. Pilots, thank you. I salute you. They've done a great job. Ronnie Coleman, Fowler Stan, he was awesome. Come on out, everybody. Come talk to the pilots. Grab a hot dog, and then we'll get back going. That's what makes it.
Hi, Eric.
Hi.
Days like today, there's very strong winds. These guys put thousands of hours in your aircraft, and they commit them to the skies for you. So we're going to do a little quick award ceremony here, and we'll get this one going. Best jet. Sponsored by Maverick Promotions. Goes to Rich Eggleston's F9F Panther.
Cougar,
I'm sorry. Can the public agree on this one? It's Andy Gideon's routine. On his Super Cub. That's sponsored by Indiana Flight Center. Best multi-engine, and not even gonna say, it's Carl Bockeberg from B&B Special, B&B Special sees awards this. Just pick one of Carl's airplanes. The Heinkel, that's my favorite personally. The Canada Air, the CC-109 is outstanding as well.
Move, chunk butt.
Move? Nah, I'm going to sit on this one.
Hands down, this guy did a great job with this aircraft, and he's flown it for you guys all weekend, weather being sideways and all. Matthew, where are you at, buddy, on your Corsair? This is presented by Robar.
Oh, okay, you're good. Yeah,
come up, Dennis Crooks. Jump in here. I don't want to get back to your lunch.
That's nasty.
Boss USA, of course, and since it's technically I'm the official representative of Boss USA here, Lee Watkins.
There you go.
Lee!
He was just here. He's over there.
he took off.
We'll skip World War One. He doesn't even know this yet. All right, best start. This one's one of my favorites. This is where we challenge a builder and a hobbyist that takes a plane that you can almost ready to fly and does something special to it. Without a doubt, John Fisher's taking a KMP B-25 and made it something special. Come on up, John. Yeah. Raven Hobbies. Didn't fly today, or actually, take it back. Flew this morning. Flew all day yesterday. David Chu and his Cessna 150.
Yeah! All right. Thank you, Ralph.
introduce you. Hey, Ralph.
Yeah, Chuckle's looking for you. I think you won something.
No way.
I think so. I'm just saying.
Okay, Best Classic. Best World War One, presented by Bus USA. I'm the representative. Lee Watkins.
There he is.
All right, and Best of Show. This is the one that, this is the cream to the cream. This is it, and this is gonna be presented by the Elkhart Airport, and since,
I want some.
And he's nowhere to be found. RJ Monroe, our local retired employee, that goes to Noel Hunt for his spectacular spat. All
right. Nice job, Noel. we can't go that far.
Fucking awesome job not hitting. Ooh. Did they plug a light?
I don't think so.